mean the rest of his career or even the rest of the season will go this way. I remember when JT Barrett first got on the scene and he came to Spartan Stadium on a frigid evening in 2014. JT Barrett looked like the best quarterback on earth. He was dropping footballs into the bucket. And I think what happened is Urban ran him too much, messed up his shoulder, and the kid couldn't throw the ball by the time. But with Fields, this is different. This is a polished, this kid really is solid. And look, man, Ryan Day is an NFL play caller. So when we look at both our teams, I think you got a Wolverine fan base who is nervous. I know we just took a couple calls of Michigan fans that are kind of apathetic about things. I don't know where Spartan fans are at. I don't vibe with Spartan fans. You know, even my buddies who are Spartan fans, like one of my friends, I was going back and forth with them texting because we don't talk during games because it'll get too heated. But it's more, you know, you're being negative. And I'm like, yeah, right. I'm just kind of telling you what's happening on the screen. Negative? We're losing to Indiana. And their quarterback's thrown 20 straight completions. Yeah, no offense. I'm sorry that my balls are not tingling at this performance. You know, I don't know what MSU between D'Antonio and Tressel, I don't know what they were doing for three quarters. You've got to adjust. Game plan ain't working. That Indiana game felt a lot like the Northwestern games of the past. And now they're going to go to Ohio State as, by game time, I expect it'll be north of 21-point underdogs. I don't know what to say. I don't. I feel like we're going to lose to Ohio State twice. We're going to lose on Saturday, and then because of what Ohio State's going to do to us physically, we're going to lose to Wisconsin. And at that point, we're in the same place Michigan's. I think you're just looking at it as the program's dead. But I don't want to hear from the apologists. I love Mark. I wish Mark would stay another decade, provided the school would spend some money and we would fire every offensive assistant, everyone. I would march all of them out, nude, and make them walk to their next destination. But the problem is, part of this is Mark's fault, because why did Mark have the play sheet marked into that microphone in 9 minutes to go? Why did the offense start burning a bunch of clock at 9 minutes? I really didn't like that. You don't play the clock with 9 minutes to go. You play to score, and you try to score. I'm very concerned State has a rough ride ahead of them. And defensively, they're just not living up to what they should be. No. Josiah Scott has not been that good this year. Josh Butler has not been that good this year. I like the safety play. I can't bite him. I think the Xavier Henderson kid's got a bright future ahead of him. Linebackers have been good, but they can only do so much. I mean, Joe Bocci can't make every tackle. I mean, hell, on Saturday, Indiana was able to manipulate everything we were doing. You know, linebackers having to run sideline to sideline. Guys, why don't we put an extra DB on the field? What do you think of that? You know, the D-line can only do so much. We don't have 8 or 9 guys like we used to. We don't. Willekes and Raekwon and Panishuk and Panishuk Jr. Like, yeah, man, that's a rock-solid front four. I think Naquan gives you some depth, maybe Beasley, but like, we're a little thin up there. There's a pitch count on these guys. They're about to hit a gauntlet, and look, I just don't see a ton of depth. They're not playing as well as I thought they would defensively, and really, I don't know. And this is a disagreement I have with a lot of Spartan fans. I'm not in love with Mike Trussell. This 3-down lineman stuff on third downs, and second of all, everyone knows how to take apart our scheme with the short crossing routes and the screen game and taking advantage of some off cover on the outside. I hate how long it takes us to adjust. And Lord knows, I don't know where our blitz package is. I really don't. And the combination of the blitz packages not being effective and us refusing to go press across the formation, I just don't know what we're doing here. Like, any time Michigan State rushes 3 linemen on third down, you're taking one of your 6 best defensive players, 7 best defensive players off the field. Why? I don't get it. And I don't know what the hell they're going to do against Ohio State. Because OSU right now, if I put OSU on a neutral field against Bama, it's OSU -3.5. I think OSU's the best team in America. So I'm kind of wondering, is apathy setting? are we all just looking at each other going, well, I hate you and you hate me, but neither of us can beat Ohio State? Is that where we're at? If you're a Michigan fan, do you view Saturday as Harbaugh's last stand? I mean, a loss to Iowa got, look, he can't convince anyone with a win Saturday that he's the answer, but he can convince everyone that he's not with a loss. A loss to Iowa Saturday, I think it would do incalculable damage to the psyche of Wolverine Nation and maybe to some of the power players at that place. Because you'd be staring down a barrel of a 5-loss season. And for Michigan State, look, D'Antonio, the shuffling of the staff, Mark is God. Okay, hey, I'll donate to the statue. Love the guy. Here's the deal. Next three games, you got Ohio State, you got Wisconsin, you got Penn State. You don't win 2 out of 3, season's toast. It's absolute toast. And I got a bad feeling. I don't know if they get one of them. Because I don't love what I see. I really don't. We'll find out just how good Michigan State is or how bad they are next 3 weeks. I got a terrible feeling about this weekend. Terrible. This Ohio State team, they might just be different. And I mean different as in, like, freakazoid. And sometimes it doesn't matter who you are. It's just all about them. I mean, the thought of Tyler Higbee lining up against Chase Young. Jesus, hide the women and children. I mean, that guy, Chase Young. Yeah, that guy's out there like me and Joe Green. It's unbelievable. He's everything. Run stopper.
Oh, he's fabulous.
Pass rusher. He's tall, but he's not lanky. He's big, but not stocky. Freakishly athletic, freakishly strong, has technique. Like, he's not like a bull rusher. This kid's got moves.
It's unreal.
Oh, my God. Can you imagine?
I wonder what that spread will be, by the way, by game. I know you mentioned it.
It'll cross 21, don't you think? It'll cross 21. It won't cross 21. No?
The money it would take to move it 4 points from what it is now. I would be surprised.
Yeah, I'm not betting. I wouldn't touch it either way. I'm with good friends, watch the game. I wouldn't touch it. I'm not betting against my own team. But I sure as hell won't bet on it. 248-539-9797. Your call's next. All right, look, Magic Fiberglass Windows. Stronger, more energy efficient than cheap vinyl. So why would you buy more cheap vinyl? And the answer is not if you have a brain. Let's talk to you about Magic Window. Family-owned, Michigan-based company. Stand by the product 100%. And that's why they do a lifetime guarantee. The owner and the staff, top to bottom, one of the first best offers. Great offer going on right now, $9,700. House full of windows, $129 a month, 2 years, no interest, that's it, that's all. Done. You tell them I sent you. I mean, guys, you can fill your house with best windows money can buy. Price your cable bill? Who are we kidding? Magic, 888-77-MAGIC. That's 888-77-MAGIC. Or you go to magicwindow.com, you get a house full of those windows, $129 a month. It's magic with a J, window.com. Magic Window, built for you, built for life.
Help Mother Waddles to help those in need by donating your car. Your car donation to Mother Waddles will provide food and shelter to the poorest of the poor. Call Mother Waddles today and change a life. Call 313-WADDLES.
Here's an equation you're really going to like. It all adds up to big savings. Let's do the math. Now you can get Xfinity Internet and Xfinity Mobile each for $30 a month. That equals awesome Wi-Fi from America's best internet provider and the best LTE on the go. It's the ultimate coverage solution. It's all in the numbers. You can save up to $800 a year on your wireless bill with Xfinity Mobile. And until October 27th, you can even get $250 back when you purchase an eligible smartphone. It's basically the perfect equation. Xfinity makes saving simple, easy, awesome. Don't miss out on Xfinity Internet and Mobile each for $30 a month. You'll get internet now with up to 100 megabits per second download speed for 12 months with a 1-year.
experienced CNC machinist for CNC OD/ID grinders and DeBurr gear technicians. BMT offers competitive wages, excellent benefits, and weekend shift possibilities. Open interviews on Tuesdays and Thursdays from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. For more information, go to BMTAerospace.com. BMTAerospace.com. That's BMTAerospace.com.
During Superstar Battery Month at O'Reilly Auto Parts with great deals on batteries and accessories. Plus, save on your next oil change with 5 quarts of Valvoline Max Life Motor Oil and a MicroGuard filter, just $28.99. O'Reilly Auto parts, better prices every day. And supplies, see store for details.
I'm Jay Farmer, CEO of Quicken Loans. 30% of Americans who are planning home improvements of $5,000 or more will pay for those renovations with a high-interest credit card. That may not be a great idea. A better idea may be to take cash out of your home with a Quicken Loans 30-year fixed-rate mortgage. The rate today on our 30-year fixed-rate mortgage is 3.99%, APR 4.08%. Call us today at 800-QUICKEN or go to rocketmortgage.com.
Rate subject to change. At 1.25% fee, receive this discounted rate. Call for cost information and conditions. Equal housing lender. License in all 50 states. NMLS number 3030.
See Andy Graham live on Van Furniture and Warren as part of their big 60th anniversary bash October 24th. Tickets are $75 and also include drinks, for terms and desserts. Benefiting Children's Miracle Network. Buy yours today at 971theticket.com/AndyGraham.
Got something to say? Text 971theticket now at 97136. Ticket text brought to you by LaFontaine Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram of Saline. Home of the family deal. Find over 5,000 new and pre-owned cars, trucks, and SUVs daily at familydeal.com.
Say Patterson fumble in there, which personally I want to see Joe McCaffrey done this season, or even Joe Milton. I laid big money on Iowa, and I could be wrong. I mean, I got him, getting 3.5 points.
Wow.
I think it's going to be one of those 17-14 games if Michigan wins, or I think Iowa's going to pour it on and rack up 28 points on Michigan.
Now, here's the thing. Listen, this is the biggest thing to me. This is where it'll begin and end. Can Iowa run the ball to any level of success like Wisconsin? Forget about 356 yards. But Iowa wants to line up and go. But the other angle, Iowa thus far, haven't played a whole lot of people I care about. I was impressed that they took away Iowa State's ground game. They're holding teams to 77 yards a game on the ground. Now, if Iowa takes away any running game, and it's got to be Shea Patterson, and I don't want to hear about what he did against Rutgers.
Oh, I don't even want to hear that.
Slinging the ball around against Iowa, I don't like that. That makes me very nervous. Very.
Anyone be confident with Shea Patterson?
How about this? In 5 ranked matchups last year for Patterson, and let's throw in the 6th against Wisconsin, right? He's averaged 178 passing yards. And a 43.8% completion rate. So if we agree that Iowa's at least a ranked opponent, if they take your ground game away, am I going to bet my hard-earned money that your quarterback is going to not do what he's done the last 6 times he's faced a ranked team? That is very scary to me if I'm a Michigan fan.
You are exactly right, and that has been the game plan for defensive coordinators since Shea Patterson arrived. Just focus on stopping the run. Everything else will handle itself. He is a one-read guy. He can't do anything else. And if he faces a good team, mistakes happen, he throws interceptions, or he's wide on the throw. They have to fix that. It's something that I don't think can be fixed other than benching Shea Patterson. That's the only way to fix it.
The thing for me, I just haven't seen Iowa versus a big-time passing offense. I really don't know if their secondary can hold their water against. I mean, look, I'll give it up to you. I like your receiver. I just don't get what you're doing. And play, it just, please, God, stop. It's whatever you did to Rutgers, it's that you need to do. Just stop. Like, you can't read into it. It's like playing a 1-AA team. Give me one. Go over to Mitch. Oak Park, 97-1. What's up, Mitch?
Hey, man, how you doing?
Good.
Been a long time.
Welcome aboard. What can I do for you?
Thank you. Yeah, so I'm actually a pilot station in from Ohio. And I remember a couple years ago when they were going to bring Harbaugh aboard, you know, me and my father, we were, you know, kind of nervous, thinking, okay, the rivalry's back on. You know, we're going to actually have some competition here. And, you know, 5 years in, it's been pretty one-sided. And, you know, I kind of hope Harbaugh stays. You know, he can't evaluate talent. He can't recruit. He can't coach. And it's too one-sided in the last 10 years. All my Michigan fans keep saying, this is the year. This is the year. And it hasn't happened. And I just don't know when Harbaugh's going to turn it around. And I don't think it's going to come soon.
Now, listen, obviously, you're a Buckeye, Mitch. So that's not exactly a fair or balanced take. I will tell you this. I don't think anyone's scared of Jim Harbaugh. I'm not going to act like he's Chris Ash. But I think the moon's off the rose. I'm not very impressed 5 years in. He's got a chance to turn it around. I've said that since the end of the Wisconsin game. I didn't alter my prediction on them or how I feel about them. Who cares about predictions, really? I thought they were a 9-3 team in the summer. I said that to you. I stick with 9-3. You lose to Iowa, I got it. Now we're talking 4 or 5 losses. And I'll be honest with you, Harbaugh's teams are not exactly resilient. They lose this game, I think it's got 5 losses. And at that point, I think everything's on the table. If I knew that Iowa's secondary could hold up to the receivers, yeah, I think it'd be a world of trouble. But you got to remember something that happened to them at Wisconsin. Jim Leonard is one of the best defensive coordinators in the country. I'm telling you, Jim Leonard is going to be a head coach very soon. Now, I'm not exactly saying that about Iowa. You got to be careful with one-game sample size. I still think Michigan is a good football team. Not great. Never thought they were good. If you don't beat Iowa, I'll have some different adjectives for what I do. Let's go to Dre, Southfield, 97-1. What's up, Dre?
What's up, man?
How are you?
Good. Thanks for taking my call.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, first off, I think the same. And I've always approached the last chance for a bit. Look, Yeah, it's amazing how much talent they have. have. And you know, if you're talented, they are so welcome. You know, like, and that when you have guys like that, you can compete in Alabama. Guys who are super talented, folks that are getting 4 or 5 per year, and they're maximizing that talent. And our program, we're not getting those players. Down on top of the door, we're not even maximizing the talent we have internally. So we're so being drawn from that. And we got to focus, we can focus on it. We can focus internally first, and we worry about the bigger piece out there.
No, and Dre, that's the thing, is it kind of takes the fun out of it, because I've never viewed Ohio State as unbeatable. MSU has beaten Urban multiple times, one of the best Urban teams out there. We did it to them twice. I've never viewed them as unbeatable. I viewed them as an obstacle. But this is, I think their program is on the way up to a new level. I think my program is on the way up. And my thoughts about Michigan are pretty well documented. All right, let's get the gross overreactions from the weekend, then we'll get back into the calls. Bogey is an overly fitted dress shirt today as well. Very, very good. 97.
Wow, that's impressive. And what else is impressive?
Here's Mike Sullivan. Distillery.
Because they've been winning all sorts of awards. And guys, I'm not just talking about local awards. I'm not just talking about regional awards or state of Michigan stuff. They've been winning awards on the national level, and they are a Michigan company over in Holland, Michigan. So check it out. Now, I've said this a bunch, and it's true, because I get this question a lot from people. Hey, Sully, where can I try Copper Craft? You know, they didn't have it at my favorite restaurant, but I saw it was at this one. Guys, the simple answer to that is you can certainly try it when you're down at any of our stadiums. LCA, Ford Field, Comerica Park, all of those stadiums have Copper Craft that you can try out when you're at one of the games. And also, seriously, they are popping up all over the place. I mean, you can go to Hockey Town, any Imagine Theater. I was just sent the other day a huge list of all the local restaurants and retailers that have it. Guys, just ask for Copper Craft at your local retailer or your local restaurant and try it out for yourself. Their straight bourbon whiskey, it's fantastic. Also, the canned cocktails becoming very popular as well for the golf course or for tailgates, that kind of stuff. Learn more, coppercraftdistillery.com, and make sure you check them out on social media as well. Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, they got it all. And like I said, it was, you know what, I know the summer's coming to an end, but it was a perfect summer drink. It's going to be, you know, some bourbon's perfect for the fall as well. I can't tell you how many times I was playing golf this summer and had some Copper Craft. It really, really is worth you checking out. Copper Craft Distillery, Holland, Michigan. Never when it's young, only when it's ready.
97.1 The Ticket.
This report brought to you by Semca. Good news in the Ypsilanti area. An earlier wreck has been cleared, 94 westbound just before Huron Street, although residual backups continue in both directions. There's also an accident, 75 southbound on the Rouge River Bridge, blocking the 2 left lanes. Fiat Chrysler Automobiles is hosting a professional skilled career fair Thursday, October 3rd from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Go to Oakland County, Michigan, works at 550 Stevenson Highway or the 15-mile road in Troy. That's a professional skilled career fair Thursday from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. at 550 Stevenson in Troy. FCA is an equal opportunity employer. I'm Michelle Penny on the WWJ 24-hour traffic center.
Coming up Wednesday at 8:02, we'll put a capper on the season with Tiger skipper Ron Gardenhire. And at 9:02, it's Wednesdays with Big Game Bob.
Ontario, Canada, it's one of the best times of the year. Colorful leaves everywhere you look, great fall festivals, glamping under the stars, that's glamorous Canada. Incredible foodie flavors and wine excursions that are perfect for a weekend getaway. We've got the best fall has to offer, but don't take too long, because pretty soon... Okay, enough. Plan your fall weekend in Ontario at fallinontario.com.
DTE believes that the energy we all use doesn't have to contribute to climate change. That's why within the next 10 years, we will triple renewables and cut carbon emissions in half. And now, we are announcing a bold new goal to reach net zero carbon emissions in electric generation by 2050. DTE has long been a leader in clean, affordable, reliable energy. And leaders don't just do what's easy, they do what's right. DTE.
Our energy grid. It powers the present and fuels the future. That's why DTE is working every day, planning and building the grid of tomorrow, investing in infrastructure that's stronger and more resilient, using advanced technologies to make it smarter
chicken like Wendy's.
So all hail the Queen of Spice.
All hail the Queen.
And the return of Wendy's Spicy Chicken Nuggets.